fate has smiled on these teams once, which team will catch your eye again in this second round matchup between the Marquette Golden Eagles and the Kentucky Wildcats? This is where both teams wanted to be, Dick. Let's not wait any longer to get this one started. The Wildcats know this could go either way, Dick. What are the keys to their success tonight?
These are the keys for me, Brad. First, the point guard has to be the floor general. It's up to him to ensure that his team executes and has efficiency on both sides of the floor. Secondly, give your big men the ball. Let them attack from down low. And lastly, don't get lazy, man. Attack the basket, grab the glass, get after the boards.
Well, Dick, let's get down to the court and let's get the action underway. They look to get it to the inside. Can't get the shot to go. Both teams looking to get things going here. The defense senses a 5-second call. Trying to draw some contact. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score.
Trying to go inside.
That spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense, not allowing him to make that turn.
Showing great patience as he waits for the reset of the offense. In the paint. Puts it up, looking for contact. Easy one. Nick, I think there's a mismatch in the post.
This may be a good opportunity for them, Brad.
Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside.
Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going. Trying to feed inside. And Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork, beating him to the spot.
Poor decision. He has no business taking that shot.
Hey, Brad, their shot selection has been questionable. Too many outside jumpers. They've got to attack inside and then out.
Now they work it around the perimeter.
Oh, right there. They missed him inside. You got to get the ball when a guy is open. That's a special art, feeding the post.
That was really a nonchalant pass. Get that sucker out of the game, man.
On the outside, he shoots from outside. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
Call this a one-man show, Brad. I don't know if it's a good thing or a bad thing.
He got the steal. The pressure got to the ball handler.
Lost some ball pressure. It was too much for him, and he lost possession.
Abrams handles the pass. It's good. I think a defensive stop on this possession, Dick, will have this crowd just roaring. There's a double team waiting there. Stolen away. Keeps the dribble as they set it up again. Dumps it in. Here he is defensively, and this is going to be an Academy Award, Dick.
Absolutely, Academy Award at its best.
And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
And there's a lazy pass. It's stolen away. Turnover. Will it turn into two the other way? Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, how about this crowd? They're enjoying this close matchup, and there's nothing better than a close game during tournament time.
He rejects it.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Keeps the dribble as they regroup. He bombs from outside. He makes the shot. Defensively, low block. Oh, nice job fronting him for the steal.
Terrific job creating the opportunity. And it really converts an offensive transition.
Moving it around the perimeter.
Hey, the crowd loved that one, Brad. But did you see the mascot? He's so excited. I think he may pull something up there jumping around like that. He's going to get hurt. Man, don't hurt yourself, big fella. They need you to cheer.
Leftwich is feeling good.
He may be in the zone right now, Brad.
Goes up for two. He can't stay with him.
He's got to get some help from his teammates on D. Very soft defensively. No pressure on a basketball.
And with that, there's going to be some open jumpers if they don't pick up defensively. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot. And off the mark. He had to hurry that one. Misses from long range. At the half, the Golden Eagles are trailing by six. We've had a tooth and nail battle so far, Dick. What was the play of the half, do you think?
In my opinion, Mr. Nessler, this trifecta is what set the tone for the offense in the first half. It represents the deep arsenal of threats this team has to offer.
Well, it looks like the teams are just about set for the second half. Let's get back to the action. Kentucky gave us a three-ball lesson, Dick, in that first half.
I'll tell you, a mighty lesson it was. I expect to see more of the same in the second half.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I am at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment. Guys?
Thanks, Aaron. Dick, you know, we always like comparing positions and specific matchups. What are your thoughts about the backcourt matchup so far?
Hey, Brad, sometimes comparisons can be misleading. If your backcourt is weaker, then you just hope to contain your opponent's guards. Keep them in check. If you have strong backcourt, as a human eraser. I love shot blockers. They add such a dimension to your team.
Patience by the dribbler being shown as the offense is reset. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
Both teams looking to get things going here. Shoots from outside. Got it.
Watch this again.
Watch the move as he works his man and out a fadeaway jumper. And in and out. He shoots from right of the circle. He buried that one from way deep. For the bucket, and he missed. Goes up for two, in and out. The shooting guard with the ball. Defensively down on low block, and there's a steal.
Oh, terrific job anticipating, reading the offense, and making that steal.
Watch out, 5-second call approaching. He makes a nice shot fake. Tries for two, doesn't go. Nicky's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
There's the pick, there's the roll. Not a whole lot of luck getting the baskets to fall lately, Dick.
They definitely aren't getting the bounces right now.
Kentucky have put together somewhat of a run here.
Maintaining it is the key, though. They've got to continue to make the hustle plays at both ends of the court.
He is going to the line. hits that one. Goes up for two. Perfectly executed. Take it away. The Wildcats will have their fans going silly if they can get a stop here. Intercepted. It's a fast break possibility. All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, an emotional message from both benches. Let's play our game. That's what got us here. And more importantly, let's believe in one another. Guys?
Thanks, Aaron. The pass in the paint, and he'll kick it back outside. The power forward handles the feed.
Let's push that basketball, help one another, communicate.
Picks off the pass. Timeout on the court, so let's go courtside. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, at this point in the game, it's about being on the same page. Each player should know what the objective is for the upcoming possession. Offensively, you must know who the number one option is, while defensively, the type of defense you're going to play or whether. Time is of the essence, Brad.
All right, thanks, Aaron.
It'll be interesting to see who responds how out of the timeout, Brad.
It's down to a one-point game, Dick.
Yes, sir. This is where the big boys start to play, Brad.
Good job defensively. They just won't give many openings.
Pressure in the basketball.
Post player flashing. Goes for the steal down low, and he didn't get it.
I thought he took a chance, and he lost, baby.
It's a three-point deficit.
And that can change in a matter of seconds, baby. Hold on.
Gave it up for the bucket.
Nice job to create the angle using the glass.
Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket, not quick enough. And a great reaction by the defensive post player.
See what they set up, Dick. That shot makes it a one-point contest.
Hey, it's anybody's game, baby. Coming inside.
Danielson receives the pass.
They have to foul to put them on the line and hope they miss.
Mr. Vitale, how about that State Farm drive of the game?
Oh, Mr. Nestle, this one's superb. The ability to get close enough to the basket and then have the presence of mind to finish off the great play. Wow, what a play.
Shot clock is dead. And they continue to foul to stop the clock. How's the front court productivity tonight, Dick?
You know, Brad, basketball is a big man's game. If you have a few on your team and are active and energetic, it makes your team that much better. Ultimately, you want all of your players to be productive, but an inside presence will separate your team from others.
And the clock stopped with a foul.
Hey, now it's a matter of clock management, Brad. They have to foul in order to get back in this game.
As we take a look here at our backcourt production.
Hey, Brad, I'll tell you one thing. Productivity from the backcourt is a must. You must initiate the offense, distribute the ball, and score. These are all things that you rely on your backcourt to do.
At the foul line. Sinks it. Makes the second shot.
Timeout. Head These kids are driving me crazy, Brad. This game is too close. I'm starting to sweat, baby. Oh, the pressure.
Change in the game plan right now, Dick.
Could be. Got to be ready for anything if you're the opposition.
They shave the lead down to three.
There's a lot of time to pull this one out, Brad.
Leftwich is trying to pump up the crowd.
He wants everyone up for the next possession.
Off the rim and no good. Dick, I think we saw a good tournament game. Both teams played pretty well, and, you know, I feel bad for the team.
They won this game, Brad, when you look at it and analyze it, because they really had all the right people shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
Kentucky is on their way to the Sweet 16 now after dispatching both their first two foes.
I'll tell you, Brad, men are bringing their A game, and their third-round opponents better be prepared, because these kids are looking to go all the way, baby.
So for Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.